weeks ago, I sat down with Ferris State defensive back Alex Thomas to hear the journey he's taken to get to Big Rapids. It's a story filled with highs and lows, great successes, life-altering mistakes, and second chances. Through it all, there's one constant, the relentless pursuit of his dream.
For Alex Thomas, football is all about pursuit.
Intercepted by Alex Thomas.
Pursuit of the ball, pursuit of the receiver, and pursuit of his dream of playing in the NFL.
I'm on a mission.
Thomas the pick.
Thomas was a Division I recruit coming out of high school. An assistant coach at the University of Cincinnati sold him on being a Bearcat and chasing his NFL dream.
He reminded me of my mom and my dad, how much they just believed how high I can go and my potential. So it's just, that's what always stuck with me.
So Thomas went to Cincinnati. As a redshirt sophomore, he played in 12 games and made 4 interceptions.
That was when I got the good buzz and the scouts and everybody was, it's pretty much when everybody knew about me and everything.
With NFL scouts taking notice, the dream was within reach. But then Thomas made a decision that would change the rest of his life.
It happened so fast, it's just like, it went from me saying like, come on, to me being behind bars.
Thomas and a friend were arrested for marijuana robbery. His friend had a gun with him.
When I went to like my bond hearing, that's when they offered me like 14 years and they was talking about stuff like that. So that's when it was just like, oh snap.
Suddenly, the dream was farther away than it had ever been. His situation, closer to a nightmare.
I mean, there's people banging, yelling. Like they knew, I guess they watched the TV, so they knew the type of person I was, so they yelling. Like, you know what I mean, we got this football player in here, we about to see if he can, you know what I mean, fight, all that.
Thomas was ultimately sentenced to 2 years in prison. Plenty of people told him he had blown his chance. The dream was over.
Even the officers used to say, like, you know, you messed up your life, you a mess up. It's just, I used all that as motivation and a chip on my shoulder.
Thomas kept pursuing. Even behind bars, he was free to dream.
Literally working out every single day, like doing 3,500 push-ups, 2,000 pull-ups, like dips. It was just like, for me to do that every single day and to be in there with like people who was like lifers, and they always telling me like, go hard, because you about to get out. You're going to get your chance.
On June 15, 2019, Thomas was released from prison. Within a week, he heard from Ferris State head coach Tony Anise.
He was pretty much just trying to see like what type of person I was and what I was really chasing. I was just telling him I'm trying to go to the NFL. Like, I just want to show everybody, I mean, that you still can do it no matter what you've been through.
You want somebody to, you know, kind of look back and say, hey, you know, I made a mistake and own the mistake, and he did that.
Thomas came to Ferris State and quickly established himself as a starter. This season, he leads the Bulldogs in interceptions. And his 99-yard fumble return touchdown against Grand Valley State swung the momentum of the rivalry game.
Unbelievable turn of events. The man who comes out of it is Alex Thomas. He goes 99.
It kind of just made me just embrace life and just like love everything that I've been through and just believe that, you feel me, it is people out here who do care about you and not what you've been through, more so like who you are now. So that's what I learned from just being here.
Thomas says the Bulldogs have given him a second family and a second chance to pursue his NFL dream. By itself, that second chance is a dream come true.
Don't give up, don't matter what it is. Whatever your dream is, go. You're the one who believes into it, so you're the only one at the end of the day can achieve it, make that goal happen. So don't matter what you hear, don't ever give up.
Thomas has faced a little more adversity this season as he's missed the last few games with a minor injury. The Bulldogs are hoping to have him back for this week's playoff game, a rematch of the rivalry game against Grand Valley State.